I'm Paul Offit, a director of the Vaccine Education Center at Children's Hospital of Philadelphia and a professor of pediatrics at the Perelman School of Medicine at the University of Pennsylvania. If you look at the 5 to 11-year-old, about 2 million of children in that age group have already been infected. 8,300 have been hospitalized, a third of whom have had to go to the intensive care unit. About a third of those who were hospitalized had no known comorbidities, meaning diseases that would have put them at risk of having a serious COVID infection. And more than 100 children have died. In addition, probably worst of all, is this disease called multi-system inflammatory disease, which is a disease specifically of that age group, of the 5 to 11-year-old, primarily in the 9-year-old age group. And that usually presents as initially an infection which was picked up serendipitously, just sort of mild infection or asymptomatic infection. Then a month later, the child comes back, has rid themselves of that infection, but has high fever, lung disease, as well as liver, kidney, heart disease, and that too can be associated with fatality. So although children are less likely to get this disease, and when they get this disease, they get it less severely, nonetheless, they can suffer and be hospitalized and die. And as long as that's true, and you can have a vaccine which can safely prevent this disease, then we need to prevent it. I think parents should be hesitant about putting anything into their body or their child's body. I think it's reasonable to be skeptical. But know that a choice not to get a COVID vaccine is not a risk-free choice. It's just a choice to take a different and more serious risk. The fact of the matter is we're still in the midst of this pandemic. The fact of the matter is children can be infected. In fact, interestingly, of the 5 to 11-year-old group, about 40% have already been infected, doing these so-called serological surveys to see who's been exposed to the virus. So if people think that their young child is not going to be at risk of this disease, that's wrong. I work at Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, and we certainly see this disease in young children. And that, more than anything else, compels me to try and do everything I can to convince parents to get this vaccine. Certainly, were I the parent of children between 5 to 11 years of age, I would vaccinate them in a second. And one other thing, I think I'm a member of the FDA Vaccine Advisory Committee, and I think that all of us who sit around that table at that FDA Advisory Committee, when we then vote to recommend that this vaccine be given, we would only make that vote if we were willing to give this vaccine to our own children.